Good morning, students. So today we are going to start the second year syllabus. In fact, by this time we could have completed 5 to 6 lessons if the situations are normal, but due to this COVID-19 crisis, we are forced to shut down all our activities, and we have been forced to live apart. Anyhow, we have to continue. So today we will start the second year syllabus of biology. First, I would like to let you know about the syllabus prescribed for the second year. For the first year, as there were 5 units, here for second year also we are having 5 units, and the details of the 5 units which we are going to learn or discuss for the second year are like this. So first year we have discussed or studied 5 units. So continuing from after 5, what we learn for the second year is that the 6th unit. That is about reproduction. And in the reproduction, we have, or we are supposed to discuss 4 chapters, and they are like this. First chapter, that is reproduction in organisms. And the second chapter is sexual reproduction in plants, flowering plants. Sexual reproduction in flowering plants. And the third chapter in the 6th unit is regarding human reproduction. And the 4th chapter is regarding reproductive health. Okay, so in the second year we are having 5 units, and among them the first unit, in fact continuing from the second first year, after 5th unit, the 6th unit, that is for the second year is the reproduction, and in the reproduction we are supposed to discuss the four chapters, and the first chapter is regarding reproduction in organisms, and the second chapter is about the sexual reproduction in flowering plants, and the third chapter is regarding the human reproduction, and the fourth chapter is reproductive health. So this is about the sixth unit, that is reproduction. So these are the topics we are going to discuss in the sixth unit, that is reproduction. So next, seventh unit is regarding genetics and evolution. And here in this unit, what we are going to discuss is three chapters, and they are like this. So chapter 5, so that is regarding the principles of inheritance and variation. So in the seventh unit, that is genetics and evolution, the first chapter is regarding the principles of inheritance and variation, and the second chapter what we are going to discuss in this unit is regarding molecular basis of inheritance. So that is second chapter what we are going to discuss in the seventh unit, that is genetics and evolution. And the next chapter we are going to discuss is chapter 7, that is regarding evolution. So this is regarding the seventh unit, that is all about genetics and evolution. In that we are going to discuss, or we are going to learn three different chapters. That is the first one, that is the fifth serial number is fifth chapter, that is regarding the principles of inheritance and variation. And the next chapter in this unit is regarding the molecular basis of inheritance. That is what we are going to discuss. And the third chapter in the seventh unit is that regarding the evolution. So these are the topics, three topics or three chapters what we are going to discuss in the seventh unit, that is genetics and evolution. So now we have understood what we are going to discuss in the 6th and 7th chapter units, and next one is the 8th unit. And the 8th unit is regarding the biology in human welfare. So the 8th unit, that is the biology in the human welfare, that is how the biology plays an important role in the welfare or well-being of the humans. So in this unit, that is 8th unit, we are going to discuss 3 chapters, and these 3 chapters are like this. So chapter 8.1, that is regarding human health and disease. So the 8th chapter in the 8th unit, that is biology in the human welfare, is the human health and disease. And chapter 9, so 9th chapter, that is regarding the strategies for enhancement. So strategies for enhancement in food production. So in the 8th unit, that is a biology in human welfare, the second chapter, or in total 9 chapter in the second year syllabus, that is here we are discussing, we are going to discuss about various strategies or tools or approaches regarding the enhancement in the food production. Enhancement means increase in the food production, which is one of the important thing, requirement of us. Okay, so how, what are the different strategies, and what are the different means, or what are the different approaches to enhance or to increase the food production, are going to be discussed in this chapter. Okay, and the next one is that 10th chapter, that is about the microbes in human welfare. So the 10th chapter is regarding the microbes in the human welfare. So as you know that microbes are both harmful as well as beneficial to us, our human beings. So here in this 10th chapter, we are going to discuss about different microbes which play an important role in the well-being of the humans, or which contribute, the microbes which contribute to the well-being of human beings, or welfare of the human beings. That we are going to discuss in the 10th chapter of 8th unit, that is the biology in the human welfare. And the next is a 9th unit, So the 10th unit, ninth unit, that is we are going to discuss or learn about the biotechnology, which is a recent concept, that is bio means life and technology is the technique which are used use the various organisms and to produce the services and the product which are helpful to the human beings. So that is what we learn here in this unit, that is a ninth unit, that is biotechnology. And here we are going to discuss two chapters, that is chapter 11 1, that is biotechnology principles and processes. Biotechnology principles and processes. And the next chapter in the biotechnology unit is that is chapter 12 and biotechnology and its application. Biotechnology and its application. So that is about the ninth unit, that is a biotechnology, that we are going to learn two chapters. First one is a biotechnology, the principles and the processes, and the second chapter in this unit is that regarding the biotechnology and its applications. What are the different applications in different fields? That is what we are going to learn here in this chapter. So that is regarding the ninth chapter. So next is tenth unit, that is all regarding the ecology. And here in this unit we are going to learn or discuss about four chapters, and the chapters are like this. So the 13th chapter, it is regarding the organisms and population. Organisms and population. And the 14th chapter is regarding the ecosystem. And the 15th chapter is biodiversity and conservation. And the fourth chapter, that is 16th one, is regarding the environmental issues. So I will write here the 16th chapter, that is regarding the environmental issues. What are the different environmental issues or environmental challenges or environmental problems we are facing today are discussed here in the 16th chapter. that is the environmental issues. So this is all about the syllabus prescribed or scheduled for the second year. So once again I just repeat the same. For the second year we are going to discuss 5 units, and the first unit is regarding the reproduction, wherein we discuss 4 chapters. That is, first chapter is reproduction in organisms, and the second chapter is regarding the sexual reproduction in flowering plants, and the third chapter is regarding human reproduction, and the fourth chapter is regarding the reproductive health. So that is the sixth unit, and in the seventh unit it is all about the genetics and evolution. Here in the seventh unit, that is genetics and evolution, we will discuss 3 chapters, and the first one is principles of inheritance and variation. The first chapter is regarding the principles of inheritance and variation, and the second chapter in the seventh unit, that is all about the molecular basis of inheritance. That is a molecular basis of inheritance, and the third chapter here in this seventh unit is regarding the evolution. So that is the seventh unit regarding the genetics and the evolution. And the next unit, that is the eighth unit, is regarding the biology in the human welfare. So how the biology plays an important role in the well-being of humans, okay, us. And that is what we discuss here. And here, once again, we discuss the 3 chapters. And the first chapter here, or the 8th one, is the regarding human health and the disease, okay. And the 9th chapter is regarding the strategies for enhancement in